show you with a video.
Hey, Sammy. Hey.
Hey. Oh, here he is. Merry Christmas.
Hey.
Merry Christmas.
What are you going to do, Stuart?
Hey.
Hybrid movie.
Scott. Bloody hell. Say hi, Des.
Hi. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Hey.
Ready for a big day?
Yeah.
Get it off. Hey.
Look, I made some white Christmas.
Hey.
Oh, good on ya. Hey. Now, how did it go?
Oh, my rumble didn't go very well.
We're going to focus on White Christmas. Nicole's White Christmas. She made last night.
How did it go? Does it taste all right?
I don't know. I haven't tried it. I tried the white.
Well, I'll tell you what. Well, I'm going to try it first.
You try a bit first. If you don't fall over, we'll have a bit later.
I put it in the fridge so it wouldn't melt and then it's all stuck.
Still hard?
Come on.
there's a map of the world on the other side of that. Wow, eh? I haven't seen these before.
What is it?
Oh, jeez. Have you seen your cat? No.
See, this is the size of the box you can.
Dismissed.
Tracy driving in half the sideways too.
Yes indeed, getting picked
she
up.
She a wonderful person.
She's wonderful indeed.
What's on for tomorrow? Christmas dinner or lunch or?
Christmas dinner or lunch at the parents' place.
Alright. That'll be good.
Having Christmas haggis.
Black pudding. Right. Christmas black pudding.
Hot or cold dinner?
Probably a bit of both.
A bit of both?
Cold ham and hot turkey.
Alright. Very good.
Official.
Official tie.
Gonna see Nick.
No! Wait till I got my other top on.
Sorry.
Just put it under the contact plan for 30 seconds.
That's not right, Nick. Do it again. Do it again.
Good. Hey, dog.
Close-ups. It's not my best point. Close-ups. Stop that screw. There's all this film you're gonna have to cut out, man.
Continue. Close your legs, huh?
Zoom in on it.
This is John.
Yo! Yo, bro! And a Merry Christmas to you too!
Haven't seen you for ages, you dirty little fucker.
What a waste.
Hey, Drew, there you go. Other side of him, he looks better.
Hey, oh, no, no, he doesn't.
Looks the same, doesn't he?
Yes.
What's going to be your tail?
How much wind, George?
Ah, tail wins, hang on. 40.
I'm at the bar. Jim's ordered a lemon squash, mind you. Huh? Oh, he's down there. He's down there at our table. Check him out. He looks bored. Scottish poofta. Hey, Eric, hey. Hey.
All I have to say for those fellas back at home is, hello.
You should say to people later, you never know what will happen later.
question of attitude, it's a matter of fact. Chance comes once, can't call it back. Hands in the balance, the way things do. Don't let your head run away with you. Lay back, baby, I'm gonna focus in on you. Come on, boys.
Go over that camera.
Hey, have a good time?
All right. How's it?
Pretty cool, son. Pretty cool.
I never said anything, so I didn't say anything. You got a real
ball. You got to keep going,
son. Fuck off.
Hey, still.
This time you go to half track.
So you're going to have a focus like this.
This time you
go
to half track. Puts me off.
Oh, they're gone. Get a couple of beers at work.
A wild turkey, there's some mate. Got me a wild turkey on the coast. They wanted me to work. They wanted me to work.
Hey, this is a face only a mother can love.
Should we make paste together?
Seemingly taking over this function, I hope anyway. It's a thing that Dennis Mitchell and a few other people are putting together, and the company will be supporting that activity because we think it's a great thing for the company. I've got to say a little bit more today because James Jones is not here for the first year for many, many years, and I'm sure that a lot of us miss James. Wandering around the place, and he was a great asset to the company over those years. Just quickly, I'd like to say that this year has been a very difficult year for business and for the company, but we've all worked very, very hard. We've implemented the immigration contract, which has been a great thing for the company, especially for the commercial division. And we then won the Thomas Cook outsourcing situation, which is also very good for the company, and that's one of the areas that we'll be driving heavily into in the future. And there's many other little contracts and things like the pharmaceutical book that Steve Murphy won in Canberra. Canberra's been very good to us, as you all know, and we look forward to the government work and participation. Everybody's worked pretty hard, reps. I've worked very hard myself this year, I'll tell you. And we're now sort of getting them. We had some wonderful news in the last few days that we've been awarded the total outsource. That's everything for legal and general insurance Australia-wide. And we've got a very big project. I've been away a lot overseas. I'm working on an enormous project for the Department of Immigration, which is very secretive at the moment, but if we win that next year, it's going to mean a very big thing for the company again. Legal and general is a significant win for us, and the managing director of legal and general, when he awarded the contract to us yesterday afternoon, said that our company won it very clearly. We were the best participant, we put the best bid in, and he said that we had the best quality company, and that's not quality from print quality, it's quality and they inspected us and all our opposition, that we had quality people, quality management, and the whole place was very, very well run, and that's why they awarded the contract. So when they were all walking around, you didn't know they were there, but it's because the place looks so good and it runs pretty well that we get awarded these things. So it is a great team effort, and I think that we're looking forward to a pretty prosperous year next year. We've got some other big things on the go, and we hope that it'll be probably one of the most successful years in the company's history. So it's really something to look forward to, and thank you very much.
Understand English? Obviously not. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name, for those of you who don't know, is Madame Beau Bedford. DSMOBE. Dirty sex maniac on the bed with everybody. And I love every minute of it. Known on the English cabaret circuit as Miss Bubbles Latrine and her performing pussy. Known in medical terms as sweetheart of the forceps. How does that grab you? You know, you sitting down there, you remind me so much of the Eskimo I was once engaged to. But he was so cold I broke it off.
Excuse me, focus on my head, thank you very much. Focus on this.
When you got that in your hand.
Okay. Oh, remember this. So, Darren, I'm playing, you know.
A bit of a mouthful.
Edit that, Stu.
So,
again.
And the best of everything to everybody else. And you can turn it off now.
Now at the canteen, filmed and produced by Stuart Garfleish.
All right. Cookie.
Marketed by Peter Gard.
Oh, not again. Miss him, Stewie.
That's good.
Yeah.
That's, well, it's not a...
Well,
we won't win.
And then last night a mate of mine and his girlfriend came out and went down to you know the Barracks in Parramatta? Great barbecue in there. Great steak and salad and stuff. I actually ended up having salad. She went back to my place and then we drank more than chocolate dessert and cheesecake and coffee and between three of us, mate.
Oh! Oh, oh yeah! You got it!
Take a chance, mate!
And there's a couple of doobies, of course. Like about 3 in the morning. And then I'm up to go to the first part.
like good, excellent before, mate, and they scooped up. They're in a different formation now, look. It's like an upside down Y. Sure, there we go. Just turned it on again. This is brilliant, look.
Thank you. Big in swinger.
Ready?
Come on!
You ready?
To the game,
mate.
really don't mind if you sit this one out. My words but a whisper, your deafness a shout. I may make you feel that I can't make you think. Your sperm's in the gutter, your love's in the sink. So your ride sails over the fields, and you make all your
animals
deals, and your wise men don't know how it feels. You'd be thick as a brick. Sandcastle virtues are all swept away in the tidal destruction, the moral malaise. The elastic retreat rings the clothes of play as the last wave uncovers the new vangled way. But your new shoes are worn at the heels, and your suntan is rapidly peeling.
say?
What was it, Mick? Six
it's
or what?
Over.
Four.
Hey?
Four. Go the other arm.
Ball. Okay. Going.
shoot through. Really? Okay, thank you everyone for making this a special day for Bob on his retirement. I personally think it's a personal privilege to be saying a few words on the occasion of Bob's retirement. It says I have the greatest respect for Bob as a tradesman, craftsman, and also as a man of the highest integrity, morals and standards. Bob's been a joy to work with, as he's such a good craftsman. And the secret behind him being a good craftsman is because he enjoys his work so much and has always enjoyed the creativity of what he's done. That'd be about right, wouldn't it, Bob?
Not really.
I want to know why you didn't say this 2 years ago.
We're just testing you out, Bob.
Anyhow, Bob, consequently, Bob's a very self-motivated worker, and really the only time he got a bit shirty with me is if I didn't have a job up his sleeve to give to him. He'd feel a bit idle, he wouldn't know what to do with his hands. The other anecdote that I might add about Bob is that when I'm introducing new apprentices or even tradespeople into the shop, I say to them, we haven't got all the fancy systems and computers and that, but the old bloke over there with the blue dust coat. The bloke in the blue dust coat over there. He knows all the tricks in the book. If you pick his brains, you'll learn a lot more than any fancy system will teach you. Bob's been in a unique position to see our trade evolve, right from when he started off as an engraver through all its various fads and phases. He's seen techniques start off, flourish and die, but those dead trades are really the cornerstone of the industry that we're in at the moment. Bob started his career 49 years ago when he was apprenticed at Harris Engravers and worked his way through the engraving industry up to when he was a manager at Halsted Press.
Where did you get all this from? Asia!
I've always wanted to be Bob Clipson, wasn't he the one on that? This is your life or whatever? Yeah, Roger Clipson? Bob was a manager at Halsted Press. Then 24 years ago, he moved over to New South Wales Print, where his engraving trade evolved into the colour planning, retoucher, graphic reproducer that we know it as today. From that period onward, Bob settled into the tradesperson that we know, and I consider him a gun planner who's always willing to take on any challenges and share his information with the young people. He's always been able to relate to the young people well. He's always kept abreast of the times, and that's also part of his secret. Bob leaves the trade now, just as the trade's about to take another evolution again into a different stage, and just as the trade's changing, Bob's changing his life into his retirement now. He's got a very good, successful and close family, and those who know him know he's an avid consumer, and he's surrounded himself with the little luxuries of life that we're sure that you'll now enjoy for many years to come, Bob. I'd personally like to thank you for what you taught me about the trade.
Thank you.
Wish you the very best in your future with your family. Enjoy the fruits of a good life's labour.
Thanks very much.
See you, Bob. Thank you.
Well, Mr. McMillan's going to try it out. Mr. McMillan's going to make a presentation on behalf of himself, his family, and the staff.
You got that on the way, mate?
I would also say thank you for the years that you've been with the family. How long has it since you've been with the
family? 11 and a half years,
12 years. It's a long, long time. And apart from whenever I came over, I would look for Bob, and he was very often on holidays. He's a very good holiday.
There should be more of them.
I was just thinking coming over the car, I thought, you've been a long time dealing with the negative, but I reckon this is a very positive move.
That's the old one.
The
helmet. So we've got some things to talk. We've got, of course, the car.
Is it rude?
No,
you're safe, Bob.
That's not right.
I'll take that on the altar, that one, mate.
I can take this home?
You can take it home, yes. And then there's a couple of prizes here. There's one from the McMillan family, which reads, the McMillan family and management have made arrangements with the Pavilion Hotel to provide Mr. and Mrs. Bob Norton with first-class accommodation and meals for a restful weekend in Canberra at a time suitable to them. That's Bob and I, and then there's a nice package to go with it to the staff speaking. So we wish you all the best.
Thank you very much.
And have a lovely retirement and come and see us.
You're here.
That's fantastic. I've got lost for words here, people. It's been terrific. I'm working with you all. That's fantastic. I don't know what to say. Thank you very much. I didn't expect this. I thought I might have got a card.
Not the complimentary. Take that with you, mate. Yours.
Well, it's a pity Lucky Rob's not here. You know, because I might have a few words with Lucky Rob.
I'm not rude, Pete.
I'm not like that all the time. Thank you very much. It's terrific. It's been good working with you. I must say, in 11 and a half years, I don't think there's one person I've ever had an argument with here. I mean, there's been a lot of slinging, you know, but not an argument. There's never been any ill feeling, and I think that's terrific. For 11 and a half years, I think that's pretty good. Put up with me that long, you know. Martha, what Colton said, when things change a bit, I'm coming back here on an extra $100 a week.
Oh, I see.
Because after what Lee said, I've got it, you know. It's got to be worth that.
Well, if you're mad, then we're going to leave. It's going to change.
I'll see you down in Tasmania.
Yes, Jamie.
All the best. Thank you very much.
Hey, the rest of the week, you're not going to do a deal when I'm down there for you.
I would actually just ring up Ken Stooper, explain what we're doing here once again, and he'll throw you in there with the first class, best room, forward, best play.
Yes, my wheels are seized there.
Thanks, Dave.
Thank you.
Call in at 5 minutes, Caesar.
Huh?
Call in at
fighting room and see us sometime. Over at the head office, you know, mate?
Yeah.
The head office of Broadway. All right.
You are the hero going on holiday.
I'll have to buy myself a nice graphite fishing reel and fishing rod.
Well, we thought it might have been known.
Catherine may need one, but I don't.
How am I going to keep it, mate?
Later.
ring up, find out, give Dennis plenty of notice, and give him another one this week.